Tonight on New Music Simulcast Special, turn your television on to City TV, Channel 79, Cable 7, and tune your stereo to Chum FM 104.5. From Stewart Air Force Base in Newburgh, New York, rehearsing for his upcoming tour, in performance with some special friends, and in conversation with Jeannie Becker, tonight the New Music brings you the return of Meatloaf.
I was blind to the world, you were too good to be true, but you were something to see, so very young and alone. And I still don't believe the way you turned on me. There was a girl that I knew. I gave you somewhere to live and then somebody to love. You gave me nothing but trouble, man, I've been such a fool. You gave me nothing at all, and let me give it to you. You talked me out of it true, man, let me try.
Queens of the night, they're looking for magic in gymnasium lights, and bless all the
about. They try not to cry, and then they try to put up. Somebody bless all these girls that I never had met. But then you will curse you after all that you've done. You're the one girl I'll never forget. You're the one girl I'll never forget. Somebody bless all these girls and everything that they do.
Loaf is rehearsing for an upcoming world tour, supporting his new album, Dead Ringer, which is already number one in the charts in Britain and moving fast here in North America. For the rehearsals, he rented a vacant aircraft hangar at Stewart Air Force Base, a top security facility only 2 hours out of downtown Manhattan, and one of the only places he could move in the immense amount of sound and lighting equipment he and his crew of 37 people needed to work with for three solid weeks. It's been 3 years since his last tour. And on this one, Meatloaf's taking no chances. He's going out with the best technical crews available and using some weird and wonderful effects. There was a family atmosphere among everybody involved in the project, even though they were working up to 14 hours a day. But it was the kind of work that's necessary to get the stage show to the level the fans will demand and give Meatloaf the kind of success he enjoyed with the album Battered of Hell and songs like Paradise by the Dashboard.
Felt about his comeback.
I always wanted to know what a comeback was. That's like, I was reading, I don't know if people know who Jim Plunkett is. Jim Plunkett was the quarterback for the Oakland Raiders last year, and he was going, I never came, I don't know what a comeback is. I was just sitting on the bench for a little while. I didn't really come back. I could always do what I could always do. It just so happens that then all of a sudden here I am doing it again, and it's not really a comeback.
But it did take a long time to, you know, to get together to do it again.
People yeah, were well,
what
it wasn't
the rumors tour. Going around about you
well,
were nuts.
Well, you know, it was just the voice. The voice just decided to take a rest. And I'm still working on it to come back 100%, you know. It's
you
not, but it's close.
Still don't feel that it's back.
No, I don't. I don't, but it's back enough that it's all I need, mm-hmm. you know.
I heard you met a great therapist from California.
Yeah, named Warren Barigian. Yeah, he's unbelievable. The voice has days, you know. It's just not, what's missing is the strength in it. In other words, the endurance. And that just comes with time.
This upcoming tour, Meatloaf has surrounded himself with an incredible collection of musicians. Terry Williams, one of the world's great rock drummers, who was available because Rockpile fell apart. Davey Johnstone, who for years played with Elton John, toured with Alice Cooper, and only recently finished work with Stevie Nicks on her Belladonna album. Other members include Steve Buslow, who toured with Meat on his first tour, Paul Jacobs, who replaces Jim Steinman on keyboards, Georgie Myers on second keyboards, backup singer Teddy Neely, once the lead in the musical Jesus Christ Superstar, and Eric Troyer, also on backup vocals. Meatloaf was Pamela Moore, who came to Meat's auditions following a successful tour backing up Bob Seger.
You know, immediately going out, she's going to be in trouble because they're going to compare her to Carla DeVito. And the problem is that people only remember the end of Carla DeVito and what she did at the end. They don't remember how she started. Carla started, it takes a while to get into the format. Carla, at this point in time, and where Pam is, was in exactly the same position as Pam, because it's real hard to figure out what I got going on in my mind. And I see Pamela in the back, like, going crazy, you know, moving. And then she'd come up front and she'll stand still. And I told her yesterday, I said, don't stand still in the front. Don't move in the back. Stand still in the front. If you want to stand still somewhere, stand still in the back.
And here I am eating in the lounge lounge.
Working all day long. It's the food rock stars eat, you know?
With a band the caliber that Meat's put together, improvisation becomes an event. This straight off the board's rendition of the Stones' Gimme Shelter sounded more like a rehearsed part of the show than a pickup jam session.
Do you think you would have made it without Jim Steinman's material?
Oh, now there you go. See, that's the question. Yeah, I would have been successful because I am a live performer, and I would have succeeded to a live extent. Without those songs, no, Bat Out of Hell would not have sold as many records, period, because each added to the other. Without me touring, Bat Out of Hell was sitting at 300,000. With me touring, Bat sold about 8 million. But one plays the other.
Through watching the crew work out for a week in preparation to tour, one thing became clearly evident. Meatloaf is a tyrant. And when it comes to making decisions, this ain't no democracy.
I want to see the Boys and Girls play.
It's a very tough tour.
Yeah, you're pretty tough. You seem pretty tough dealing with the band and ordering people around, but you've said that your bark is worse than your bite.
I say please and thank you. I'm polite.
You're not a dictator.
I am, but I'm polite about it. A very polite dictator.
At any level, Meatloaf is competitive and likes to run the show, even when it comes down to a quick break for football. Can you see any other reason for a 300-pound quarterback? Meatloaf was vulnerable only once during these rehearsals, when they were testing a hoist used to fly him out over the band for a grand entrance. The whole band conspired to leave him hanging, angry and frustrated. Every time his feet touched the ground and he thought it was all over, they hauled Meat back up again. At the end of the day, all this is just good fun, and the band really has come together as a working unit.
You're for love about?
Well, The Dead Ringer for Love is about, it's about a teenage, actually it's about a teenage boy, and he's got fake ID, you know, just like every teenage boy, and he goes to this bar every night to, you know, and he doesn't have a car or anything, and he sees this older woman, and he's been watching this older woman forever, and she must be at least 19, he must be at least 16, you know, she's got a car now, she's got one, and finally he gets the nerve up to go make his move. And she scares him half to death and backs him into a corner and winds up taking him home anyway. But it's very animalistic. I mean, it can, you know, you don't have to be 16 or 19 and you don't have to be an older woman. That was just my description at the moment. But I put in a middle section, I used African logs and jungle birds and everything, because I figured that that what takes place in those, in these singles bars or in bars when guys pick, it's very basic. It's a very basic emotion, you know, it's like your place or mine. My managers got the wild idea to use Cher, because we'd been trying a lot of different girls on Dead Ringer for Love, and they said, oh, you ought to come bring in Cher. And I kept going, no, I don't think she's right for the part. And they kept going, yeah, but if she is right for the part, imagine the video you can do with it, the film. I said, yeah, she'll have a great concept of it, but I don't know. I said, the song's real hard to sing, you know? it's in a weird key for females. And they said, well, bring her in. I said, well, I'm not going to go in and tell this star, this woman, who is a real talent and everything, that she's not good enough for my song. I feel like an idiot. And they said, well, we'll be there to do it. She came and they didn't. But luckily, she walked in, and within 2 minutes of being in the studio, we were working together great. And then doing the film, I knew that, she was a natural, because she understood the song right away. A lot of people didn't, the dramatic intent and da-da-da-da-da-da, it goes on. And and so she brought in her dancers, and I brought in my softball team. And thus you have the video of Dead Ringer.
What about your appeal? I mean, you've been considered a sex symbol for quite
Absolutely.
Some time. Has married life changed any of that?
No, I still have my charm.
What do you think your secret is?
Hey, I'm from Texas. My secret with women is that I actually understand women. I don't understand men at all. In an argument between a man and a woman, I would always side with the woman. I think most men are jerks. Ha!
Good, I'm glad you said that. Listen, thanks a lot, Meat. It was great talking to you.
Yeah, now I'm going to get stoned by all the men.
Oh, yeah, great. Okay.
Not all the men are jerks, but they have certain attitudes. And they ought to think about, changing it around a bit. You know what I mean? Okay. Bye, y'all. We'll be right back.
tomorrow because City TV brings him back alive. It's Saturday Night Live. See you on City next. The Police, Toots and the Maytals, Susie and the Banshees, and more.
To be nice people.
Call free 800-257-1234.
Those who are richly blessed in this life have an obligation to pass along those blessings. That's the opinion of our next nice person. If you're a fan of rock music, you may already have heard about the good work being done by Bob Weir.